Hi, my name's Joseph Mercorella, and I'm the CEO and co-founder of Lumary. My journey began in 2010, and I was very fortunate to be working for the South Australian Government as a consultant, advising on different systems to replace legacy ones for the aged care and disability sector. And it was a great opportunity, a great time, because obviously there was a lot of change that was about to proceed. I wasn't savvy and wary of that, but I was obviously fortunate in a position to be in there. The technology that we were using was Salesforce. And Salesforce was also something new to me, but also gave me another opportunity to experience and learn something new and evolving. And I really appreciated the platform and its capability in extendability and functionality that it offered out of the box. Our partners, I thought it was a great opportunity to keep working in the Salesforce arena and section. And so therefore, we created a systems integration business, which enabled us to build custom software in different verticals within the South Australian community. It was a great opportunity, a great time, because we really got to learn the capability of the platform and truly understand how it can work and fit with different business models. At that time, we also engaged with South Australian Government and we're still engaging on healthcare solutions. And there was the transition and change of the NDIS, or the National Disability Insurance Scheme, coming in. And so we had a great opportunity then to understand what was going on. We got approached by a number of healthcare providers at that time. They were really concerned about, you know, how they were going to evolve and change and what technology they were going to include in order to be effective. And it was all new to us at that time, but it gave us a great opportunity to get insight into the way that the market was set up and how they were equipped to handle for things. At that time, we did further analysis. We made great connections with organisations and peak bodies like Connecting Up. And good insight into what the market was made up of. And we basically found out that there was a real change that had to happen. And if it wasn't going to happen in the way that it was, in a way that would be scalable, then there were going to be some problems for the community. So Lumary was formed, identifying, understanding those challenges, those pain points. And we created a solution in market that would build for the long term for partners and customers in that space. I want to talk a little bit more about the current landscape and what the landscape was in the past that's brought us to this point today. I think it's important to understand healthcare is becoming more complex. And it's becoming more complex because we're moving from a volume-based care system to a value-based one. And in that shift, as we know, there's more levels of compliance, information that needs to be captured, validation of service quality and so forth. We've got the NDIS, which is about service control and price control. So there's a lot of regulations coming in, which is changing the way in which the experience, the care worker or caregiver, needs to interact with the recipient of care. The other aspect of things as well is that healthcare itself has been great for experience from a digital perspective. If you're a family and friends involved with someone who needs care, whether they're living with a disability or they're elderly, there's not great interaction from a digital sense or from transparency or real-time communication from the caregiver to the individual that's receiving care. And it's far behind what's expected in our day-to-day lives. You know, in our normal use, we've got our phone, we've got many apps on there, and we can interact with data real-time in many experiences, but we can't do this right now in healthcare, and we want to, and we need to. The other aspect of thing is, as well, is that Australia and other countries around the world are moving to a more self-service engaging model. But in order to do that, we need to change our technology in the way that we consider and interact and provide our care operationally. Healthcare providers aren't tech businesses. Your focus is on giving care, and it should be. So it's organisations like Lumary and other software vendors that should be focusing on improving technology to enable the care to be provided and received much better than what it is today. There's other systems in play too that didn't exist before. The landscape is more competitive. There's more choice and control for the consumer and the individual and family receiving care, and it should be. But this changes the dynamics of the way that the marketplace was before. And this is an important foundation principle, because the technology that you need to incorporate changes dramatically. Historically, there was a reluctance to have a cloud-based system. It was everything was on-premise. I remember when we first began and started talking in the sector, there was no notion or concept of being cloud, and so it was a real challenge. But without the cloud inclusion, obviously we can't ever have real time and being transparent information back to the care recipients. The sector overall is having to make more difficult choices on their technology and the way they incorporate it. And for the most part, from what we can see day to day, there's such a different level of experience and understanding as to how these decisions can be made. And it's actually challenging for us to engage within the community, but it's also challenging, I can see, on the other side, as a healthcare provider, of trying to consume this technology in the way that you need to do it. I'd like to talk a little bit more about now about the current pain points and challenges that we see healthcare providers experiencing today. There still seems to be a lot of older issues emerging, and I think a lot of that comes from the mindset and the lack of willingness to change. So I think change is upon us 100%, and adoption for change must be included within not only the business and the technology teams, but the technology itself to enable the change. One number one problem that we see all the time is a lack of systems or no systems, and then that relating to a lot of systems of interoperability, if there are systems together, but they're not connected and not speaking with each other. The result of this is that it causes issues where there's no single source of truth for records of information, whether that be for the client or the customer or for the employee, and they're both just as important as each other. Another thing that we see that is an emerging problem is healthcare providers have a desire to communicate and be more effective with the information that they share back to the families and those guardians and individuals that are part of the care giving process. But there's just the inability for these healthcare providers to actually share that information. They either don't have the technology or they don't have the data in a state to share. And that's a big problem. The other aspect of issues that we see is systems that aren't in a state of scale. Or not in a state of sustainability. And so we think there's a lot of opportunity there still to create a technology base which has this included. The other major issue as well is that there's inflexibility in the current systems or platforms that the healthcare provider is using. And this is obviously a challenge. If you're an organization who's looking to evolve and grow and change and adopt quickly, you don't have the necessary constituents to make that effective. And without this flexibility, as I was mentioning before, you don't have that ability to adapt and change at the speed in which you need to. And unfortunately, we see lots of situations where there are systems that the healthcare providers don't have access to their data, like genuine ownership of the data, and aren't able to extract the data at will. So therefore, reporting and insights and analysis in the business doesn't exist. And this is obviously really important if you're in a highly competitive market and you need to get good analysis and understanding of how your business is tracking. The time to change has passed. Technology is accelerating faster than ever before. This is obviously a key challenge for healthcare providers to keep up with. You have regulatory bodies like the NDIS who are providing more restrictions, more control over the way services are being delivered. You have a healthcare market that is demanding more digital connectivity. You have a need and a shift and change in healthcare in general where we want to move to a more proactive healthcare model. You know, instead of being so reactive, we want to be able to know and understand who we can engage with. Recognizing that there's an increase in complexity in order to operate the business, your business more effectively today is a must. And technology is the savior for this. But making the right decisions and choosing the right software systems and technology is a hard one. And we're not necessarily all equipped to make the right decisions. I want to make sure that there's two key takeaways today. The first part is the evaluation criteria that you can use in order to pick your software vendors or technology partners. And I'm going to provide 7 steps of my own that I use day in, day out to form our partnership and alliance group. The second part is reframing your boundaries and understanding how your business practice and the principles you should now include in order to be effective for the future, based on what we've understood today. Lumary is built on establishing partnerships and working with new technologies every day to expand their platform. So the information and advice I'm going to give is firsthand as to what we found successful in order to evaluate and align with the best partner for your future. The first one and primary one for me is market traction. Evaluating whether they're new or they're existing, whether disruptive or whether they're expanding, these are key principles to evaluate your technology partner. The second is R&D investment. What are the investments they're making? How are they growing? How are they scaling their business? If they're not going to be around in 5 or 10 years' time, is that someone that you should partner with? You need to be convinced that they're going to be there for the long term and that they're operating their business in a way that's going to be effective and scalable for the future. The platform, the technology, and the integration capability that they're using today. Does the technology provider you want to partner with enable you to expand constantly in the future? If we're trying to be adaptive and be flexible in the way we're operating, then this must be a must in your evaluation criteria. You need to get under the hood of the business, the technology provider and partner that you're about to align your future with. You need to understand their engagement approach and their overall culture and experience that they're bringing to their business, because that's going to have a direct impact and effect on yours. There's definitely telltale signs that you can see, but get involved and understand and engage with the delivery team, the success team, the technical support, have a good understanding how they're sharing and being transparent about the information around their technology. These are all important signs to evaluate your partner for the future. Have a look into the industry experience and the partners and their alliances. If you're not comfortable with the people that they're partnering with, just remember, you're not just buying them, you're buying their partners as well. So this is an important part of your criteria. Their overall product capability and price is obviously important, but that comes way down the list. If those first 5 or 6 points are not taken care of and they're not well addressed, then there's not even any point looking at the product and the price. And last but not least, as we currently do now, is the verification stage. Make sure that you contact and get the references from either customers or other like partners that they're involved with to ensure that they're a good one for the long term. Part two is about reframing the boundaries of your business. Technology is a must, and building a digital framework that is flexible, scalable, and sustainable are the key criteria for your decision making. Use the evaluation criteria and partner with the technology providers that seek to truly understand your business and that will grow with you. Let them take care of the complex so you can do what's best. Only interact with systems that are accessible and have integration capability. This is a must to ensure that you have the choice and control of over your overall digital solution. Data that is connected, consistent, and accurate will provide you with the ability to gain proper intelligence in your business and make more accurate decisions. Partner with a tech solution that won't outgrow your business. It's really important that as part of your evaluation, you can understand and see proof of why and how they will continue to grow with you. You need partners for 10 plus years, not 2 or 3. Don't fear the use of middleware tools to help you organize your data into actionable information, but be fully savvy and aware of what the dependencies are and the maintenance associated with this. And change management fatigue is a real thing. We've seen it happen many times already, and it adds extra unnecessary challenges when you're transforming your systems. So make long-term buying decisions, because they're not just financial implications that you'll have, but there will be also human resource ones as well.